With this, we will be moving ahead to the next speaker that we have, Ms. Sevati. She is the People and Organization Director at Royal Canin. She will be sharing with us a case study on Royal Canin that will talk about the wellness at workplace with mindfulness. Sevati is a business leader with rich experience in deploying human resource practices and tools to nurture successful and sustainable businesses. She loves to mentor budding human resource professionals and enjoys writing and sharing thoughts. Over to you, Sevati.
Thank you so much, Vrinda. And hi, everyone. It's a pleasure and a delight to be here. I'd like to start with these few lines. Imagine all the people living life in peace. You may say that I'm a dreamer, but I'm not the only one. I hope that someday you'll join me and the world will be as one. This is a very famous song, Imagine, by John Lennon. It is particularly relevant for people who are passionate about topics like mindfulness, because we really believe that it's possible for all of us to be more peaceful and organizations to be a better version of themselves as well. My name is Sevati. I'm happy to share the journey that I had at my organization, Royal Canin. I lead people and organization here. Royal Canin is part of Mars globally. And we really believe in this vision of the world that we want tomorrow starts with the way that we do business today. So at the very onset, well-being is very integral to the way that Royal Canin and Mars operate. And that really helped this journey. Let me talk a little bit about what we did, when we did, how we did it. And happy to take any questions. Please feel free to keep this interactive. Put your questions in the chat and I'll answer them as I go along. So the specific journey that I'm talking about happened this year in May and June. We were in the middle of a devastating COVID second wave. Every member of the organization was affected in some way or the other. I know that all of you also would have felt the impact where, you know, things just seem really dark and gloomy. Work from home had also been happening for more than a year, which meant that there was some bit of exhaustion creeping in from just doing work online, not being able to meet colleagues. And people were talking about mental health. That was clearly a priority. But leaders really needed a language of what is mental health? What is mental well-being? How do we go about it? So sometimes the intent might be there, but the language was missing. And that's the space where I connected with Sapan and we designed something for Royal Canin. What did we do? We had a 7-week mindfulness training journey. This is quite important. Many leaders believe that it's good enough to give an introduction. We can't really make stuff mandatory. They do one session and then they feel that now people are all aware. Now we are going to have a mindful set of associates. There'll be less fights in the organization. But alas, habit change takes time. So right at the beginning, we decided that we would keep it 7 weeks. The first session was mandated and everybody joined in. It was an introduction to mindfulness. Subsequent sessions were optional. It was kept on a Saturday. But we did have a fairly large amount of the organization participating out of their own volition. During the week, we shared multiple articles on what are the different benefits about mindfulness. And we kept doing different polls to help people get aware of what are the practices they themselves have. How mindful are they really when they are living their life? And also how mindful are they in taking back some of the lessons from their Saturday practices. So it's not just enough to attend, but how much are they doing? So this was our journey, sharing a little about what we learned. So language is quite important. And I think the first thing that all of us together learned was what mindfulness is all about, which is awareness, attention, and acceptance. And this itself was a huge benefit for associates. Because so far they had these fuzzy ideas. Is it only meditation? Is it religious? Is it something that I can really do? And how will this help me? So when we talk about awareness, attention, and acceptance, it becomes clear and simple of what it really means. We also talked about the importance of taking breaks in any day. We talked about the fight or flight syndrome and the way that our brains are structured and why it is so important to bring mindfulness so that we can be the best version of ourselves. We saw how anxiety could sometimes overtake people. We looked at, learned like concepts like metacognition, which is observing how we think. And again, that really helped associates figure out, okay, this is something I can do in real life. It's not something that is very strange, but I know that next time that I'm anxiety, I have to take a step back and I have to observe my own thoughts and things can be simpler. So it was a combination of tools, topics, techniques, and practice, which helped. And we gave a lot of references of how this is applicable across different fields as well. Now, what was the impact? I have just shared what my associates have shared. Overall, there was huge positivity, not just immediately after the program, but it's been a few months since then. And many associates have come back and shared that it was really needed. It really helped. This was a time when people were losing loved ones and it was very difficult to talk about the pain that some people were going through. And people came back and shared that because of this kind of a sustained intervention, they were able to come out of what was a otherwise challenging situation for them personally. So a lot of impact that was created. For HR practitioners and for leaders who are like really thinking about starting out on their mindfulness journey at the organization, these are some of the design principles that I and Sapan kept in mind as we designed the whole intervention. The very first one is that it's a skill. And whenever we talk about any skill, we talk about cooking, we talk about cycling, we talk about playing the guitar, it requires practice. So knowing, watching MasterChef Australia is not going to make us great cooks. And similarly, attending programs by Sapan is not going to make us mindful. We have to practice ourselves. So hence, we deliberately made it 7 weeks so that people got adequate practice, and that's something we encouraged. We also felt it was important to cater to all kinds of learners. So some people learn better when they see things, some people learn better by hearing, some by practicing, and we kind of kept it a mix. There is enough research now on behavioral economics, which talks about how nudges can help behavior change, and the whole polling technique that we used was based on that. Peer learning also is a big one. So we had good sponsorship from the general manager of our organization who attended every single session. And that he himself shared his experience. So that helped. And finally, measuring impact. This is my final slide. I know that many of you must be familiar with ADKAR model for change, which talks about awareness, desire, knowledge, ability, and reinforcement. And whenever there's a gap in any of these, the change doesn't stick. If I really look at our journey around mindfulness, I think where we could have perhaps done even more is reinforcement. So my provocation to all of you here is that we can think about mindfulness training just as we think about sales training. So when we talk about functional training in your organization, you do it every month, every quarter, every year. You kind of keep at it till it becomes a skill. Whereas for mindfulness, we just talk about awareness and then do not take it further. I think it's an encouragement to all of us to think about it in a little more structured way and see how we can measure results. The reinforcement really helps if we are serious about bringing about this change. These are some of the dilemmas that I went through, and I'm sure all of you will go through as you navigate your journeys. Role modeling and sponsorship was important. We had the general manager, but we didn't have it from some of the other leaders. So how do we present a unified picture where all leaders are passionate about the topic? Mandatory versus optional is another one that we keep talking about. My predecessor said we can't make it mandatory, and I wonder why. But I know it's still in the space of good to do, but not must do, and we dealt with it. How long should we reinforce and how should we measure progress? So we had our solutions, but it's something that we should co-create as well. With that, thank you so much, Sapan, for this opportunity. I definitely hope that this journey continues and we build a community together where mindfulness becomes very, very commonplace in all our organizations. Thank you.